A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 14th April, Sunday, on the front page you have Anil Ambani firm got tax relief after Rafael deal, French paper. So this is fresh revelation which has come regarding the Rafael fighter aircraft deal. A leading French newspaper has reported on Saturday that is yesterday on 13th April, that Anil Ambani's French registered telecom company was given tax waivers worth 143.7 million euros. Shortly after the announcement by Prime Minister Narendra Modi of the purchase of 36 Rafales. So, French authorities cancelled a tax recovery claimed for years of 143.7 million euros from a French company of Mr. Ambani's Reliance Communication. So, the dispute was settled between February and October 2015 when the Indian and French government were negotiating the sale of these 36 Rafale fighter jets. So, that is the benefit which Reliance company got because of the Rafale fighter deal is what is the connection which has been put forth here. Then next is oil import from Iran may be reduced as US mulls waiver. So this is regarding now US considering waiver on the sanctions which have been imposed. So oil imports from Iran may be reduced. So, India actually faces two deadlines from the US on two separate issues. One is regarding the GSP, Generalized System of References. So, that GSP deadline is also there. That was 60 days since the US trade representative notified cancelling GSP status to Indian exporters. We have already discussed this. GSP status gave Indian exporters benefits because it is for developing countries and underdeveloped countries whose commodities would be imported into USA at very low tariffs. So that benefit has been removed. So Indian exporters would have to, you know, have to pay higher tariffs now, and the tariffs which are due or which are applicable for all. So it has been for 60 days. So this was done on the notification actually has been signed. Now what is happening is that the decision can may be delayed till May 23 on GSP status. So we'll see, because these are deadlines which are approaching next month, that is in May 2019, and that is May 2, 2019 is actually the deadline here. And another is on Iran oil sanctions waiver. So Iran oil sanctions waiver was provided by US to 8 countries. So this was for 6 months. This was for 60 days. This was for 6 months. So these 6 months are also ending on May 4. So India was also benefiting. India continued oil import. But the condition for waiver by USA was that, means exemption from the sanctions, was that you reduce your oil imports. So now that waiver term is also ending. So that is also a deadline approaching. Then below you have Jallianwala Bagh, a shameful act. So this is British High Commissioner who paid homage at the Jallianwala Bagh Memorial, which is there in Punjab, in Amritsar. He expressed regret. Then below you have waste dumping. NGT seeks action report. So this is regarding action report being sought regarding dumping of municipal solid waste near a school in Haryana. So National Green Tribunal has sought a report from Haryana State Pollution Control Board and the civic body. And this is regarding NGT seeks report on damage due to illegal mining. So NGT has directed Central Pollution Control Board to submit a report on the environmental damage caused due to illegal mining in Uttar Pradesh. On page 8 you have Nizamabad may make it to the Guinness. So Guinness Book of World Records. This is actually in Nizamabad parliamentary constituency. There are 185 candidates who have been contesting for one seat. So this has already attracted attention from the entire country. So now it may get into Guinness Book of World Records too. So here you can see, first time in the country since EVMs have been introduced in 1998, as many as 12 ballot units were present at each polling station. So the record was, so far the record was for conducting polls with 4 ballot units, and this is 12 ballot units together. So this is, they have to be connected, because on one ballot you cannot have, you know, you can have a limited number of names. So this is Nizamabad in parliamentary constituency in Telangana. Then on international page you have will send migrants to sanctuary cities. This is US President Donald Trump, who said that he is seriously considering funneling detained illegal migrants into the self-declared sanctuary cities that opposes tough immigration laws. So he says that this is what these sanctuary cities in the country want. So we'll send all these illegal migrants them and let them stay in that particular area and they take care of it. Then this is China enlarges its circle in Europe. So Italy and Greece have also joined Belt and Road Initiative, and China has lined up investments in other countries also. So this is regarding Belt and Road Initiative making inroads into Europe. So this is it. Italy, we have already seen Italy had agreed to Belt and Road Initiative, and now even Greece. On business page, you have India becomes net steel importer, a first in 3 years. So demand for high quality steel has increased and we have started importing steel, a net steel importer. We do export steel too, but there has been more of import of higher quality steel domestically. So this is first in 3 years now. Then on Sundays, you have this FAQ coverage. First one is, will the El Nino factor impact the monsoon? So we have been discussing over the week about El Nino and it how it may be a El Nino year and may affect monsoon in the country. We have below normal monsoons. And this is F-16 claims and proofs. India claims that F-16 was shot down, while Pakistan claims that no, it was not. US also said no, F-16 is missing from Pakistan, because F-16 aircrafts are provided by USA to Pakistan. And this is capturing the image of a black hole. So this is the black hole image which was captured, that was in news. So this is the detailed study regarding that too, how astronomers click this picture, which we have already discussed. So this is it.